Even though Wi-Fi is better than ever these days, it will never be as good and reliable as a regular old hardwired cable. But not every house or apartment has Ethernet cabling installed, so you may be forced to use Wi-Fi. And that might not be a problem if you have very strong Wi-Fi signal and your router is centrally located, but if it's not, you have to choose between using a poor Wi-Fi connection or somehow running a long Ethernet cable across your home on the floor or running it through the walls or vents or something like that. But what if there was another way, such as using existing non-Ethernet wiring in your house to carry an internet signal instead of an actual Cat5 or Cat6 Ethernet cable? Turns out, you can, and with a few different methods actually. In this video, I'll be talking about two of them that I'm aware of, and I'll go over how they work, and we'll also, of course, be testing them out to see how well they work. The first is called MoCA, which stands for Multimedia over Coax. This technology allows you to run an Ethernet data signal over coaxial cable lines. The adapters, which you just put one on each side of the coax line, have both coax and Ethernet ports on them. So you take an Ethernet cable from your router and put it into one adapter and then attach it to the coax cable. And then on the other side, maybe in another room, you plug your computer into the other adapter just like you would an Ethernet wall jack. And you can actually use this even if you're already using the coax cable for your TV, which is why there are two coax plugs on each adapter. So clearly the advantage here is that pretty much every house and apartment will have coax cables run to many rooms, even if they don't have Ethernet. And if your coax cable network is connected together, you should be able to add more than just two MoCA adapters, and they can all talk to each other, which is nice, so it doesn't have to just be a direct line. Now, MoCA claims to be able to carry gigabit speeds, but of course, we'll test that out to see if that's true. The other technology we can cover is called powerline, which literally uses the electrical wiring in your home to carry an Ethernet data signal between adapters. We'll get into how this actually works in a bit, but the cool thing about this is you can theoretically plug these adapters into any AC plugs in your home, even on different circuits, though not ideal, and it will still carry the signal. And you aren't even limited to just two adapters. In fact, depending on the model you get, you can have up to 64 nodes. Now, some brands claim the powerline can also handle up to gigabit speeds, depending on conditions, but again, we'll have to see if that actually holds up. So before we get to testing the speeds of everything, let's go over how each works exactly, and we can begin with MoCA. There are actually different generations of MoCA technology with different speeds. The current latest version you can buy is called MoCA 2.0 Bonded, which has a theoretical max throughput of 1,000 megabits per second. And there's actually an even newer version called MoCA 2.5, which can do up to 2,500 megabits per second, but apparently is only available to ISPs, so us regular consumers can't buy it yet for some reason, hopefully in the future. Anyway, the way MoCA works shouldn't come as a surprise, since ISPs have been using coaxial lines coming into your house for internet for years. So the idea is the same. You have a coaxial cable capable of carrying large amounts of data, whether that be an analog TV signal or digital signal, and we simply install two adapters that are capable of transmitting data over that kind of cable and also translate it onto an Ethernet cable to continue on to the computer. And coaxial cables carry data using high frequency electrical signals just like Ethernet cables, just using less copper connections. A coax cable technically has two wires inside, one in the center and one on the outside, whereas an Ethernet cable actually has eight. When we go to install the MoCA adapters, how we do it will depend on whether you're using the coax cable already for TV or not. If not, it's really dead simple. On one end of the coax cable, which is probably a wall outlet, you attach the cable to the coax in on the adapter and the Ethernet to your first Ethernet device, like the computer or even a Wi-Fi extender. On the other end, which might go to your cable cabinet, like in a closet, you do the same thing and attach the Ethernet plug from the adapter into your router or whatever. And that's it, then you have a hardwire connection. If you're already using the coax cables for TV, the setup is just a bit different. In that case, the TV coax signal goes through your house kind of like branches of a tree. with the incoming signal from the cable company coming in one wire and then being split into different floors and rooms and maybe split multiple times. But with MoCA, you don't actually need the connection to be direct. It should work through the splits in the network, even on different branches. So what you do in that case is you go to whatever rooms you want to use for Ethernet outputs and plug the first coax cable that's in use into the coax in, and then another cable from the TV out connection and connect that to wherever it was going originally. So basically you're just putting this adapter in the middle. Although keep in mind that these MoCA adapters apparently won't work if you're using them with satellite TV service because they use the same frequencies on coax as these adapters. Now onto powerline, which is actually even easier to set up, but we'll have to see later if it works as well. Literally, all you have to do with these is plug two of these into different AC outlets and press the pair button on both, and they'll be connected. Two things to keep in mind are that you can't plug these into a power strip because they will filter out the modulations used to carry the data. And also, these adapters will work better if they are connected on the same circuit, which you can determine by looking at your circuit breaker. It's usually something in the same room. How these power line adapters work is they modify the electrical signal going through the house. Typically, AC electricity in your home will either be 60 or 50 hertz depending on your country. Whereas these power line adapters combine that with a frequency anywhere from 2 to 100 megahertz, using the original AC frequency as a carrier signal. So visually, that might look like the signal going from this to this, where the data signal is kind of being hidden within the big main signal. All right, so now we know how MoCA and power line are going to work, let's go ahead and test them out. I'm going to be using a bandwidth testing program called iPerf3, and it's a free command line program, and it works great. First of all, I want to get a baseline of how fast a direct Ethernet connection would be between two of my computers. So no switches or routers or anything between, literally just an Ethernet cable plugging into each computer so we can get the maximum speed of the LAN controllers and just get a baseline. When I run it, you can see that it maxes out at about 940 megabits per second, pretty close to gigabit. So if either technology can match that speed, that would be pretty darn good. Let's start by testing out the power line adapters, and we'll do an ideal test first, where both adapters are in the same room and on the same circuit. And remember, these claim to be able to do gigabit. So you can see I have one plugged into one wall, and that Ethernet cable goes around to my desktop, and the other power line adapter goes into my laptop right here. When we run the test, you can see we're only getting about 90 megabits per second, not anywhere close to the theoretical gigabit. I also tried running this test with multiple parallel threads, it's another option in this program, and the result was the same. So if that's the result in ideal conditions, what is it in not ideal conditions? Well, this time I took the adapter and plugged it into the kitchen, which is the room over, and is on a different circuit. And this time, as you can imagine, it did even worse, getting only around 30 megabits per second, and again, the result was the same with parallel mode. But that wasn't even the worst one, because in my kitchen there's a plug on the side of the counter, and when I tried that one, it barely connected at all. You can see when it does connect, it's only about 1.5 megabits per second, but most of the time, it fails. So clearly, power line performance really depends on your home's wiring, and probably is not great if you need fast speeds. But if you're connecting something that doesn't require fast speeds and doesn't have Wi-Fi, perhaps like a printer or something, it might still serve a purpose. So power line is a bit disappointing. Hopefully, the MoCA adapters will perform better. For the first test, we'll do another 100% ideal scenario. So here we're literally connecting them with a 3-foot coaxial cable, and the connection is between two laptops right next to each other. When we run the tests, well, they do a lot better. Right around 940 megabits per second, which we just determined was the maximum, even for direct Ethernet connections in my case at least. So this is looking real promising. I will point out that I had to run iPerf with parallel threads to get these speeds in this case, otherwise it was only getting around 400 megabits per second. That's not a bad thing, it's still getting the gigabit over coax, it's just something to be aware of. If you can't seem to get the maximum speeds when testing it, That might be why it might need to be run in parallel mode. And now for a more real life scenario, I took one of the MoCA adapters all the way to the other side of the apartment where my coaxial and Ethernet cables terminate, and yes, I know it's a complete mess of cables, don't worry about it. The other adapter is in the room with my desktop, so there's at least 50 feet of coaxial cables between these. And for the moment of truth, it's again around 940 megabits per second. The average here is slightly lower than that because the first few seconds are always lower as it apparently warms up, but for all intents and purposes, there is no noticeable loss in speed. One thing to note is that MoCA adapters do introduce about 3 milliseconds of extra latency, which in most cases is completely negligible, but just be aware of it. So as you can see, at least in my experiences here, we've determined that while both of these technologies work, MoCA seems to be far superior. Powerline is more convenient because you probably have way more AC plugs than coax plugs in your home, but the speed just isn't anywhere near Ethernet and is probably slower than Wi-Fi in some cases. MoCA, on the other hand, at least when they're connected directly with no splitters in between, seems literally just as fast as Ethernet, which I was not expecting at all. Keep in mind though that I do not have television signals on these coax cable lines, and I couldn't test it because I don't have cable TV, so I'm not sure how that would affect anything, if at all. Still, I think these tests will be useful for anyone who might want to improve their options for expanding their home network. All right, so if you want to keep watching, guys, I've got some other videos right on here you can check out, and be sure to subscribe. I make a few new videos every week. I'm looking forward to hearing from you in the comments, and until next time, have a good one.